cái chọc. អង្គជំនុំជម្រះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសហគមន៍ការសហគមន៍ការនៅថ្ងៃនេះឲ្យខ្ញុំបន្តស្ដាប់សកម្មកម្មដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋវិនិច្ឆ័យជឿងយ៉ាងចែកបញ្ចប់ហើយនឹងផ្ដើមស្ដាប់សកម្មកម្មសាក់សីដែលមានហើយមានពី
សូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសម្រាប់សវនាការនៅថ្ងៃនេះកាលាបញ្ជីកាត់សម្គាល់ឃើញថាគ្រប់ភាគីទាំងអស់នៅរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានដោយឡែកលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រោមសាលសវនាការនេះដែលលោកស្នើសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធិមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទប់សវនាការមានខិតលះបង់សិទ្ធិរបស់លោកនួនជាបានប្រកល់ដល់កាលាបញ្ជីរួចហើយតាមម្ដងដែលនឹងត្រូវមកដល់សក្ខីកម្មបញ្ចប់នៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺលោកជឿងយ៉ាងចែកលោកមានវត្តមាន
ដែលគាត់អាចដឹងគឺគាត់មិនមានទំនាក់ទំនងញាតិលោហិតឬញាតិពុនជាមួយនឹងតាមបណ្ដឹងរដ្ឋបវេនីណាមួយដែលត្រូវបានទទួលស្គាល់នៅក្នុងរឿងក្តីនេះទេឬជាមួយនឹងជនជាប់ចោតទាំងពីររូបគឺលោកនុនជានិងលោកខៀវសំផនឡើយសាក់សីរូបនេះបានធ្វើសម្បត្តិនៅចំពោះមុខលោកតារំងដែររួចហើយកាលពីម្សិលមិញនេះសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
អគុណកញ្ញាជាស៊ីហងជាដំបងនេះអរញញាមរះសម្រាប់ឬសម្រាប់សុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាជាមុនសិនអរញញាមបានទទួលលិខិតសូមលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនេះរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចុះថ្ងៃទី8ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2015ដែលបានបញ្ជាក់ថាដែលគាត់មិនបញ្ហាសុខភាពជាក្បាលជាចង្កេះមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបានមិនអាចផ្ចង់អារម្មណ៍បានយូរនិងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពយ៉ាងខ្លាំងមុខក៏មានប្រសិទ្ធភាព លន់ធំលះបងសិទ្ធចូលរួមនឹងមានវត្តមានដែលផ្ទាល់នៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មការនេះនៅថ្ងៃទី3និងថ្ងៃទី8ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2015បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុពិនិត្យសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្យប្រចាំការពិនិត្យព្យាបាលថែទាំសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនៅអវតកចុះថ្ងៃទី8ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2015បានគាត់សម្គាល់ពីស្ថានភាពសុខភាពរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជានៅថ្ងៃនេះថាមានអាការៈឈឺចង្កេះវិលមុខធីងធូងពេលអង្គុយយូរមិនអាចផ្ចង់អារម ឲ្យអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកនុនជាចូលរួមតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពបន្ទប់ខាងក្រោមសាលសន្និបាតនេះផ្អែកលើមូលដ្ឋាននេះនឹងយោងតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធាន 65
Yes, I do. Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. Good morning, Mr. Civil Party.
Yesterday, we ended discussing Taping and his function.
I will get back to him shortly.
I would like to return to the discussion we had before.
About the
events that you described yesterday took place. In your interview with your lawyer,
you said that the
killing of your family took place in March 75. 5 months earlier, you also talked to some people from what is called the victims' support section,
and
In that document,
D22/317/5/1,
there's no French and no Khmer, it's English, ERN 00561343. In that document, you describe two incidents, two killings, one of your family, and one 6 months later. And the killing of your family in that report is dated at the beginning of 1975.
My question is
about the time period more general. You described that the events took place in what was called District 18. Is it correct that the area, what is called District 18, was already liberated by the Khmer Rouge in 1971? So much earlier than 75. So Sector 71 was already governed by cadres like Taping. Is that correct?
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Une courte observation sur la nature du document qui a été lu par notre confrère. Comme je l'ai dit à plusieurs reprises dans cette audience, ces rapports qui sont effectués par la section de soutien aux victimes sont des rapports, c'est-à-dire qu'il n'y a pas de contact direct entre l'unité des victimes et la partie civile. C'est simplement un résumé qui est fait de la constitution de partie civile. Simplement pour que ce soit clair, puisque à ce moment-ci, il n'y a pas de contact entre l'unité des victimes et la partie civile.
Mr. President, I take the lead co-lawyer's word for it. I just read whatever I was reading in that report, but my question is not so much about that report. My question is to the civil party, wasn't Sector 18, or sorry, District 18, already liberated by National Front Forces or Khmer Rouge Forces in 71, so 4 years before 75. Of course, Mr. President, I'll rephrase. Yesterday you spoke about events that took place in Kampong Ling District, and you said that there was also known as District 18. Is it correct that District 18 or Kampong Ling District was already liberated by the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge in 1971? As a matter of fact, I think yesterday you said that Kampong Leng district is also known as District 18, which I think it is, Mr. Civil Party.
Do you know
the secretary of Kampong Leng district in 1972?
Kampong Leng
Have you ever heard of a man named Uk?
Look, lop, loo, chmuk, barak, manet,
chmuk,
secretary
of District
18. Have you ever heard of a person, Bun Thang, alias Chan, who was the Sector 31 chief in which District
18 was situated?
I understand, Mr. Civil Party. Let me now return again to Daping. Do you know whether Daping himself was Vietnamese?
Have
you ever heard someone say that he used to serve in the Vietnamese army? Assuming that I might be correct, Mr. Civil Party, and that the District 18 was already in the hands of the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge. Is it possible that the events that you described took place long time before 1975?
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Je suis désolé, M. Copé, d'interrompre votre interrogatoire, mais je voulais juste une précision, à savoir quel était le fondement de vos questions pour affirmer, pour alléguer que Tapim était un soldat vietnamien.
Judge Lavergne, as you know, the investigators of the investigating judge never investigated the events described by the Civil Party. We had to do our own research, necessity, and based on the case file, I inclined to think that District 18 was in fact already in the hands of the quote-unquote Khmer Rouge in 71.
ខ្ញុំគិតថាស្រុកដប់8នេះគឺបានស្ថិតនៅក្នុងដៃខ្មែរក្រហមនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ1976ហើយតែពីមកថាអាចមានសំណួរមួយថាបានថិតនៅក្នុងដៃខ្មែរក្រហមនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ1976ហើយតែពីមកថាអាចមានសំណួរមួយថាបានស្ថិតនៅក្នុងរដ្ឋាភិបាលវៀតណាមកាន់កាប់កន្លែងនេះពីព័ត៌មានដែលយើងចេញពីសំណុំរឿងខ្ញុំសូមឲ្យលោកឆ្លើយបានច្បាស់ទៅនឹងសំណួររបស់ខ្ញុំ
But you have to do it with this answer.
ប៉ុន្តែ លោក ចក្រម ក៏បីតែ បាន ឃើញ ចម្លើយ ដូច តែ ខ្ញុំ ឆ្លើយ
Je pense qu'il vous sera redit que si vous voulez poser des questions, il faut que nous puissions comprendre le fondement.
សូម លោក បង្ហាញ មូលដ្ឋាន ឲ្យ បាន ច្បាស់ ដើម្បី អង្គ ជំនុំ ជម្រះ បាន យល់ ផង
May I just ask one additional question, because I'm not sure I got it right. Are you referring to the personal case file now as a basis for questions? Or are you referring to the case file we all base these proceedings on?
Exactly. What?
It's the case file defined in terms of E3 numbers.
Well then, kindly provide us the E3 number.
Sorry, if you insist, it's
E3/1852.
There is only an English guy.
It's
0089 Mr. President, I just wanted to note for the record because it hasn't been stated outright that the document that counsel has just referred to is a S-21 confession document. We have, of course, addressed this issue before. These are documents that are implicitly suspect. Often the information contained in them was obtained under torture.
I believe that should be the conclusion of the line of questioning based on this document.
លោកមេធាវីបន្តកូពេការតាំងសំណួររបស់លោកហើយដូចជាមិនបង្ហាញនៅស្ថានភាពនៅមូលដ្ឋាននៃការតាំងសំណួរច្បាស់លាស់ទេហើយចុងក្រោយលោកក៏និយាយមិនបានច្បាស់លាស់នៅឯកសារដែលជាមូលដ្ឋាននៃការផ្ដល់មូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការតាំងសំណួរនេះដែរលោកមិនអាចមិនក៏បីធ្វើដូច្នេះទេនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសំណាក់ការនៅទីនេះក្នុងការស្វែងរកការពិតនោះយើងទៅខំជឿជាក់ថាលោក មិនក៏អាចមិនក៏បីធ្វើអញ្ចឹងទៀតទេលោកអាចតាំងសំណួរផ្សេងទៀតដោយមិនអោយផ្អែកលើមូលដ្ឋាននៃការតាំងសំណួរដោយផ្អែកលើឯកសារដែលបានមកពីការធ្វើទិរុណកម្មនៅស.21នោះទេខ្លឹមសារណាខ្លឹមសារនៃឯកសារដែលបានមកពីការអំពើធ្វើទិរុណកម្មទាំងឡាយដែលនៅក្នុងបានមកពីមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខស.21ទេ
I I'm not sure how you can see so quickly that Le Hor was in fact tortured, but the main gist, as I was explaining, Mr. President, of my question was, and that I have, I'm basing myself upon Kiernan, that particular part of the West Zone was already liberated in
71.
Maître Copé, est-ce que par hasard Ben Kiernan se fonde sur les mêmes sources, à savoir des aveux de S21, ou est-ce qu'il a d'autres sources? Si c'est le cas, on serait heureux de les entendre.
There are in fact many other sources,
Judge Lavergne,
there's in fact a map, I think it's an American intelligence map describing the period 70-75, and you can see on that map that except for the big cities, most parts of Cambodia were in fact under the control of the National Front Forces.
And
if you look at that map, and I'm sure Keenan did as well as others, that part of the country was in the hands of the National Front, including Kampong Luang District, District 18, Sector 31, by the way, not 71, as I understand it was translated. So no, Keenan is not basing himself upon confessions.
Mr. President,
លោក សរុបការងារបានច្បាស់លាស់ទេគេមានងើងើម្ដងហើយម្ដងទៀតដូច្នេះលោកនិយាយបានច្បាស់លាស់ហើយនិយាយឲ្យបានក្បោះក្បាយតែម្ដងទេយើងអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកនិយាយដដែលបញ្ហាដដែលនេះម្ដងទៀតទេនិយាយឲ្យច្បាស់លាស់ហើយតែម្ដងនឹងបានហើយ
Thank you, Mr. President. I actually just wanted to make a quick point of clarification in relation to the premise of the question. I actually believe that, what the civil party stated initially this morning, which is that Kampong Leng is in District 16, is correct. While this debate can be had later, potentially through filings, I think the premise of the question may be incorrect.
If I may briefly respond, and then I will move on, Mr. President, it was this civil party in his supplementary statement who says that Kampong Leng district was also known as District 18. Something that he repeated in response to a question from his lawyer. Kampong Leng was District 18, which, by the way, is also confirmed by this document that I'm not allowed to use. But my question to you, Mr. Civil Party, isn't it correct that the place where you were living was already liberated by forces of the National Front or the Khmer Rouge, whatever you want to call it, in 1971? Then my last question on this subject, would it be possible, or is it likely that you're referring to Khmer New Year maybe in 71 or 72, or
1973, or
1974?
Um, I will move on to the next subject, Mr. Civil Party.
As I might have heard earlier, events
that you did described have not been investigated at all by this court before. And so we only have your testimony to rely on. Is there anyone in your surroundings, maybe Mr. Dali, or anyone to whom you told the story, to whom you described the events that you described yesterday? Is there anyone who could corroborate your evidence?
When you returned to Cambodia in 1982, was there anyone whom
you told the story? Is there anyone who could confirm? Is there anyone who saw the events? Anyone at all that we can ask a question?
Mui the Luban Ribrom Tita, to by Chet Dung Panakna, got the young actor, Sue, the Mabin Chet, be away the Luban Dung Ta, she had car, keep band Dung Chung, do look by Taminetna.
Yesterday, Mr. Civil Party, you asked a question about what you call your memory loss. In your statement, you say, I forget approximately 30% of things. As a result of your injuries. When you say that you forget approximately 30% of things, where does that come from? Why 30% and why not maybe 50% or 10%? What makes you say that you forget things and that you forget approximately 30% of things? In that same paragraph, Mr. Civil Party, you also speak about mental issues that you are having, particularly, quote-unquote, when I'm doing too much work. What did you mean with mental issues? What kind of mental issues do you have? I understand, but that what you're describing something that we call physical injuries. You're talking about mental injuries. Is there something
sometimes
not going well in your head?
Um,
Let me move on now to the events that you described. In the report on civil party application that I just referred to, made up by people from the victim support section who apparently never spoke to you. But they, in their report, make a distinction between two events that you described. One, at the beginning of 1975, when allegedly your family was killed, and one in July 1975, when around 40 villagers were killed. And in that report, it is described that you were part of the group of 40 villagers, and when you were hit on the back of your neck, rather than at the beginning of 75, when your family was allegedly killed. So my question is, when you were hit in the back of your neck, did that happen when you were with your family, or when you were part of a group of 40 villagers? So let me read to you an excerpt from that particular document. First, they relate the alleged killing of your family at the beginning of 75. And then they go on. In July 75, around 40 villagers, including the applicant, you, were taken to be killed at the east foot of the Gang Quebec Mountain by an unknown militia controlled by Tap Ping. So the report made by whomever, the victims unit support section, that's incorrect. You were not part of a group of 40 villagers when you were hit on the back. Is that correct? That's clear, Mr. Civil Party. Now, you also yesterday spoke about 2,000 Vietnamese families being relocated. Do you know what happened to these 2,000 Vietnamese families that you described yesterday? What happened to them?
Maybe I was
not accurate. Maybe you didn't say it yesterday, but you said it in your supplementary statement of your interview by your lawyer. You say, quote, there were about 2,000 Vietnamese families that were relocated up the mountain to Dar Village. So just to be sure, I'm referring to those 2,000 Vietnamese village families who were relocated up the mountain to Dar Village. What happened to them?
Vietnam, perhaps people crossed the Chumleet to the Phnom Nung. That mean away cut long Chumpu. Net on no the look man dung te.
You what dung?
Let me now move on to when you were on the ferry going to Vietnam and the things that you said about you and other Vietnamese people being quote-unquote traded or bartered for salt and rice. Can you explain again why you thought you and the others were traded?
រូបលោកហើយអ្នកផ្សេងទៀតគេយកលោកទៅដូរនឹងអំបិលនឹងអង្ករតើមូលហេតុអីដែលនាំឲ្យលោកអាចនិយាយបែបនេះបានបាទហើយខ្ញុំទៅចូលសាឡុងដែរដូចថាអង្គការខាងសាឡុងហ្នឹងគេនិយាយអញ្ចឹងមកនិយាយតភ្នែកសមុខតខ្ញុំហ្មងថារូបហើយរស់សុកថ្ងៃបានអង្គអំបិលដូរហើយទេអាហ្នឹងលើតាមគេនិយាយអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំនិយាយអញ្ចឹងអង្គការខាងសាឡុង
Ankar cannot make to speak. Who was it that said that to you?
But Chang Kim Chang Su Tha Ta Ne Na Da Ni Ye Oi Lok Lu Pia Da Lok Tha Mình Nung.
Khang Việt Nam Ke Salon Khang Việt Nam.
So it was the Vietnamese Ankar or the Vietnamese Vietnam. Who
ឬក៏ជនជាតិវៀតណាមទេដែលនិយាយថារូបលោកហើយនឹងវៀតណាមផ្សេងទៀតគេយកទៅដូរគឺមិនមែនគឺខាងខ្មែរមិនខាងខ្មែរទេអ្នកនិយាយប្រាប់លោកគឺខាងវៀតណាមទេតែអញ្ចឹងឬទេថាអញ្ចឹងហើយ
And of course, I presume you have no idea where this Vietnamese person had his knowledge from, correct? Just to confirm, you never heard that you were traded or bartered in Cambodia itself, or you were never told such a thing by Khmer,
right?
Is that correct?
Ba.
I'm finalizing my questions now, Mr. Civil Party. Is it correct that you have absolutely no idea what the reason was for the alleged killing of your family by tapping?
មិនដឹងថាឪពុកម្ដាយរបស់លោកនេះត្រូវបានគេចោទប្រកាន់អំពីអ្វីទេដែលត្រូវទៅពាងារទៅសម្លាប់នោះអញ្ចឹងមែនទេ
ហឹងនឹងអត់ដឹងហើយអត់ដឹងមែនដឹងយកទៅសម្លាប់ដឹងយកទៅសម្លាប់អត់ដឹងរឿងប្រកាន់ប្រកយអីទេ So then do you agree with me there is zero evidence that your family was killed because they were Vietnamese?
អ្វីទាល់តែសោះដែលបញ្ជាក់ថាការដែលគេយកឪពុកម្ដាយលោកទៅសម្លាប់ដោយសារតែឪពុកម្ដាយលោកជាជនជាតិវៀតណាមនោះទេ
បាទឃើញឃើញនាំមុខដូចច្រើន 3-4 សំណួរហើយហើយនៅបន្តទៀតយើងឃើញថា
ថាមេធាវីមានកម្រិតបច្ចេកទេសខ្ពស់ណាស់ប៉ុន្តែត្រូវការតាំងសំណួរចុងក្រោយនេះគឺប្រភេទសំណួរនាំមុខដែលមិនគួរឲ្យជឿថាមេធាវីនឹងប្រើប្រាស់បែបនេះទេអញ្ជើញលោកតំណាងថាបញ្ញាអន្តរជាតិ
Thank you, Mr. President. I object to the form of the question.
It's appropriate to ask the civil party whether he has any knowledge of his family was killed. បង្រៀនភាគីម្ខាងទៀតឲ្យរៀនតាំងសំណួរទេលោកអាចជំទាស់បានសំអាងហេតុនិមូលហេតុជំទាស់បានប៉ុន្តែលោកមិនគប្បីប្រើវិធីការបង្រៀនភាគីម្ខាងទៀតឲ្យសួរណែនាំឲ្យសួរតាំងសំណួររបៀបណានោះទេសាក់ថ្មីមកឆ្លើយតបនឹងសំណួរនេះទេ
Right. Mr. Civil Party, is it correct that you
have information at all about the reason for the arrest of the family?
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
បាទតនេះផ្ដល់វិទ្យការជូនទៅក្រុមសហមេធាវីការពីក្តីលោកខឿនសំផនដែលមានឱកាសតាំងសំណួរនេះដល់ចំពោះដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបាលនេះរួមនេះ
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour.
Bonjour,
Monsieur Cheong Yang Chat. Je m'appelle Antagissé. Je suis co-avocat international de Monsieur Pusampan. C'est à ce titre que je vais vous poser quelques questions complémentaires. À l'audience d'hier, à 11h09, vous avez évoqué le départ de nombreuses familles de Kandal vers Dar en disant qu'elles étaient au nombre de 1000. C'est le chiffre que vous avez utilisé hier. Et vous avez également indiqué que parmi ces familles, il y avait à la fois des familles d'origine vietnamienne et des Khmer. Ma première question est de savoir comment vous avez eu ce chiffre de 1000 familles. Mais que vous avez estimé à partir de quoi c'était un lieu de rassemblement c'était, comment est-ce que vous avez sur quelle base vous avez fait cette estimation Et ce groupe sur lequel vous avez fait cette estimation, où se trouvait-il à ce moment-là? Et J'ai bien compris que les personnes avaient été dispersées. Ma question est de savoir, au moment où vous avez fait votre estimation, où est-ce que ce groupe de personnes était situé, à quel endroit? J'ai cru comprendre de vos réponses à M. le coprocureur et également à mon confrère Copé que Taping, et corrigez-moi si je me trompe, aurait été à l'origine de ces déplacements. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition? Alors, j'ai du mal à m'exprimer. Ma question était de savoir non pas si Taping avait tué d'autres personnes, mais si c'était lui qui était à l'origine des déplacements des personnes de Kandal vers Da. Je n'ai pas eu de traduction à votre réponse. Je ne sais pas s'il y a eu un problème. Donc, vous venez de me confirmer que c'était Taping qui était à l'origine de ces déplacements. Donc, ma question est de savoir comment savez-vous que c'était lui qui était à l'origine de ces déplacements. Est-ce que vous savez s'il y a eu une annonce collective dans votre village d'origine pour annoncer ce transfert? Ou est-ce que ça s'est fait d'une autre manière? Est-ce que vous savez comment cette annonce s'est faite?
Mau tăng môn và mua giúp môn chơi vô sẽ đất tư thế này nó đặt cho nên lưu cốt tam lưu cốt nên tức tam lưu tức chẳng lưu cốt cái đánh tư na như mình đánh lưu cốt nâng tức nó cái đánh tam tới lấy nâng nâng cái đặt tay cho mình đang tập phân đứng đi ở miền bắc và ca y tiết
Donc, si je comprends bien, les gens sont simplement venus, ils vous ont dit « allez à tel endroit », c'est ça? Et qui a fait cette annonce? Dans votre déclaration complémentaire, réalisé à la suite d'un entretien avec votre avocate, document E3-5631, ERN en français 00898372, ERN en Khmer 00897513, ERN en anglais 00678292. Au deuxième paragraphe, voilà ce qui est indiqué. environ 2000 familles vietnamiennes ont été envoyées dans la montagne, dans le village de Dar. Environ 200 familles cambodgiennes ont été déplacées également. Elles ont été envoyées dans la montagne pour cultiver des terres. Environ 1000 familles sont restées dans les villages flottants pour pêcher du poisson pour les Khmer. Fin de citation. Là encore, ma question, monsieur de la partie civile, est de savoir le chiffre que vous avez indiqué. Vous m'avez confirmé tout à l'heure que c'était une évaluation de 1000 personnes. Là, dans le document qui résulte de l'entretien avec votre avocat, vous dites 2000 familles. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous indiquer quel est le bon chiffre, si vous le savez?
เลขมวยตัวเลขมวยนั้นน่ะตรมตรึนํา
Avant l'évacuation, il y avait à peu près 2000 familles qui étaient à la fois vietnamiennes et khmères, n'est-ce pas? Enfin, d'origine vietnamienne et khmère. Donc, si je comprends bien, le chiffre de 2000 familles uniquement vietnamiennes telles qu'il figure dans votre déclaration complémentaire n'est pas correct. Je me contenterai donc de cette réponse. Je voudrais maintenant passer à un autre point que vous avez abordé, que vous venez de me confirmer en disant que vous avez dit que lorsque les maisons ont été vidées pendant ce déplacement, un certain nombre d'entre elles ont été brûlées. Est-ce que c'est bien au moment où vous partez de votre village, que cela s'est passé? Répondant, je crois, à une question de Madame le juge Fence, vous avez indiqué que votre livret de famille était conservé chez vous et qu'il aurait été détruit en même temps que votre maison. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris votre déposition? J'ai compris aussi qu'à un moment, vous dites que les livrets de famille auraient été consultés par les autorités de l'époque. Est-ce que vous pouvez préciser à quel moment le livret de votre famille aurait été consulté et par qui? Donc, quand vous avez dit à monsieur le coprocureur que les livrets de famille ont été consultés, à quel événement faisiez-vous référence? Mais vous parlez de quels livrets de famille qui ont été consultés? Celui de votre famille,
hein? ខ្ញុំគប់អាយុធ្វើឡើងតៃបងខ្ញុំគប់អាយុធ្វើឡើងតៃធ្វើសម័យឡើងតៃនឹងសម័យមុនទៀតប៉ុន្តែថាគេដល់ប្រើហ្នឹងដល់សម័យខ្មែរក្រហមអត់ប្រើឡើងតៃឡើងអីទេគាត់គាត់ឈ្មោះចូលគាត់ឈ្មោះចូលគាត់អត់ធ្វើតែបានយើងទេដូចសម័យឥឡូវទេប៉ុន្តែគាត់គាត់ឈ្មោះម្ចាស់គ្រូសានឹងទេហើយគ្រូសាម៉ាត់នេះគាត់យកប៉ុណ្្នឹងខ្ញុំឡើងតែប៉ុណ្្នឹងទេ
Oui, mais hier, répondant à Monsieur le procureur, j'avais compris de votre réponse que vous indiquiez que les Khmer Rouges, entre guillemets, avaient consulté les livrets de famille. Donc ma question est de savoir, est-ce que maintenant, ce que vous dites, ce n'est pas qu'il y avait une consultation des livrets de famille, mais que c'était des questions qui étaient posées? C'est ça que je dois comprendre de votre réponse?
ໂດຍຄິມໃຫຍ່ຖ້າສໄໝຄະໄໝຄະຫອມນັ້ນກໍອາດຖືລັງຕາຍຈັ່ງໃດປັນລັງຕາຍນັ້ນຖືສໄໝລະນໍລະອັນນັ້ນກໍເພີປິດລະນໍໄວ້ສໄໝນັ້ນດາເປໂຊສໄໝຄະໄໝຄະຫອມນັ້ນກໍຖືສໍາບັດກູຊາໄວ້ໂດຍຖ້າເມກູຊາກູຊານັ້ນມາແນ່ໃຫ້ຍີ້ຖ້າປັນນັ້ນໃຫ້ກໍໃສອາລັງຕາຍນັ້ນກໍມັນກໍຖືສໍາບັດກູຊານັ້ນເມກູຊາໃສກູນກູຊາໃສກິດດັກນັ້ນປັນນັ້ນ
Hier, à 15h06 et 17 secondes, voilà la question qui vous est posée. Et les Khmer Rouges ont-ils consulté ces Lantai ou ont-ils demandé à voir le Lantai de la famille? Votre réponse a été la suivante. Ils ont consulté le livret de famille, ils ont consulté tous les Lantai. Fin de citation. Donc ma question est de dire, est-ce que maintenant vous revenez sur votre déclaration et vous nous dites qu'ils n'ont pas consulté ces livrets de famille et qu'ils ont simplement posé des questions?
Khmer của họ nó mò xuống lăng tai hai, thử xuống lăng tai nó, cái thử mưa dương lăng tai ban đang chọn chít Việt Nam, chọn chít Khmer, hay chọn chít Chàm. Nó như vậy tập anh nó, đau là đuôi tha còn, đó là mấy Khmer của họ nó cái mò vô lăng tai nó cái thứ à vô ấy, số A, số A, số B anh chắc cái đạn này, cái đạn nó từ ta nó mà cổ xa nó từ mà phẩm anh nhé, đôi cổ xa nhóm buôn phẩm nhé, cái đạn buôn phẩm nhé, phẩm phơm mấy nhé, cái đạn phơm mấy nhé.
Ça, j'ai bien compris qu'il voulait connaître le nombre. Ma question, donc je la répète, est-ce que, oui ou non, votre famille a montré votre livret de famille à une quelconque personne arrivée sur la montagne? Donc ma question est de savoir quand vous avez répondu à Monsieur le coprocureur hier que les Khmer Rouges avaient consulté le livret de famille, à quel moment faites-vous allusion?
Cái thưa nó ngay cái thưa để thằng cô xa nhưng mua ấy cái đạn mua nằng côn trao mua ấy cái đạn nằng ngay nó cái căn lưỡi đay cái hay cái căn lưỡi đay cái mình ao dương đăng đấy còn những phép nắng phải dương lăng tay cái ao dương với nhau dương tục nơi nơi tia đó cái phải đánh dương tránh cái phải chun dương tay đánh tránh cái đặt tên trao bắt thôi.
Your Honours, these questions are unnecessary and repetitive. The evidence that came from this civil party yesterday was that the Lang Tai, the family record book, was kept by his mother in his family. And he said Whenever we moved villages, we had to show it. Now, there were a few different movements that have taken place. The first one is a movement from his place of birth, say Takoi village, to Kandal village. The second movement, which was a forced movement, was from Kandal village to Da village up Kangkep mountain. So it's my submission, Your Honours, that these questions are unnecessary, have already been answered, and there is no need to cause confusion with further questions of this type.
Là où ma consoeur voit de la confusion, moi je cherche des clarifications. C'est le principe même de l'interrogatoire de toutes les parties de la défense. C'est quand il y a des choses qui apparaissent peu claires, on demande des clarifications. Donc je ne vois pas quel est le problème de ma consoeur sur ce point. J'essaye d'être tout à fait clair avec le témoin en lui rappelant ses déclarations, en lui demandant de réagir. Ce sont les explications plutôt de monsieur de la partie civile qui m'intéressent et non pas les explications de sa consoeur. Ma consoeur plutôt qui aura le loisir de plaider si elle le souhaite en fin de course. Pour le moment, je cherche des clarifications de la part de la partie civile. En tout état de cause, j'ai entendu la réponse de monsieur de la partie civile et je continue. Hier, à l'audience à 11h13, Monsieur de la partie civile, vous avez évoqué la mort de vos parents en disant que votre mère, lorsque des personnes vous ont arrêté, aurait perdu connaissance ou aurait été en Khmer, c'est ce qui est apparemment ressorti en Khmer, aurait été exécutée dans la maison. Est-ce que vous pouvez préciser ce point et évoquer ce qui s'est passé au moment de l'arrestation de votre famille?
Cho mui nó một mình nó muối xài mui cho của xa nhưng ở hơi cho chô mà xài hay của xa ai mà khang thiết buôn nẹt đi và đây buôn pí con pì cho mà xài thì cái vô tơ nó chích mình đau nó và hai mà rồi mai thì khi mình ao cho nơi chích mình đau thì mà đo mui vô tơ sẩm lấp nó đăng sẩm lấp giăng na giăng này thế nhưng mà khi to phần này không thấy phần tay đỏ vô khi ông tơ quay trăm đại nâng nhưng khi mai ơi nhưng địch ngọc nâng đại tập ọt.
Lúc đàm ra rồi mà xoay tốp nâng xùm nô thế, lúc đạp xùm nô ở chỗ bác hay xoay tốp lấy tới chôm nâng xùm nô bàn hơi. Chỉ viên lúc ở thà thị bài chả ấn kia nâng dọc thật đây ở thà thị bài bằng lúc dọc mà xua tuynh lúc đôi cho vấy đại kỳ bàn xua cả lòng bọn ni. Ní chìa nê tệ bị thi nê ca xua đánh đó tam phá lâu tà la ca. Hơi vì ọt bà giáo ích bởi vô lúc mà xoay tốp tên nâng xùm nô đấy phía ký xua thì mình thì bị tăng thẩm nua trong khói bà lục xây mà đoàn tiết rồi có tình đoàn thất đập thẩm nua rồi bà lục xây mình dù thế mà mình đi lời những cứ liệt ngay mình chom tình đoàn thẩm nua đã xua thì
hier à l'audience en Khmer à 11h13, vous avez parlé de l'arrestation de votre famille et il est ressorti en Khmer que vous avez dit que votre mère avait été exécutée à votre domicile. Est-ce que vous pouvez dire si c'est le cas, oui ou non?
Est-ce
que vous pouvez indiquer quelles étaient les personnes qui ont procédé à cette arrestation et combien ils étaient?
Semua yang mendang ni, hari semua yang mendang, mau pembayi ni,
Ces huit personnes, est-ce que vous les aviez déjà vues auparavant? Vous ne savez donc pas s'ils étaient des miliciens, des soldats, ni de quel ressort ils étaient, à savoir soit de la commune, du village ou du district. Vous ne savez pas. Est-ce que c'est correct?
Đăng thư ca nơi phong nương mong ca pi nơi nương nương mong mà mai họ mà đào admin sanh chun ca nương admin sanh chun sanh ít
Et qu'est-ce qui vous fait dire cela? Quelle était la différence entre des personnes de la population de base et les miliciens? Et quel était l'uniforme ou quels étaient les vêtements des miliciens qui auraient été différents? Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire, vêtements ordinaires? Est-ce que vous pouvez les décrire? J'ai bien compris votre déposition. Vous voulez dire que les miliciens portaient des vêtements comme aujourd'hui, alors que les gens du peuple de base étaient habillés avec des vêtements noirs et un foulard autour du cou. C'est bien ça? Vous avez indiqué avoir été amené, si j'ai bien compris votre déposition, à un kilomètre de Dar. Est-ce que c'est bien exact? C'était un kilomètre que vous avez parcouru avec votre famille jusqu'au lieu où vous avez vu les deux fosses dont, que vous avez évoquées hier? Ma question était de savoir, ce lieu se trouve bien à un kilomètre de Dar, c'est bien exact? J'en viens maintenant à, lorsque vous vous êtes réveillé vivant et que vous avez pu sortir de la fosse, vous avez indiqué que vous avez
បាទបាននឹងបាទឡានីដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអំពីប្រកាសសម្រាប់ចាប់ពីពេលនេះទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10:30នាទីសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្រាប់ការមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលការត្រួតត្រាដល់កន្លែងសម្រាប់ដែលបន្ទប់រងចាំនៅមគ្គសិសដល់ដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបវនីរូបនេះនៅក្នុងឡុងពេលចូលសម្រាប់នឹងអញ្ជើញគាត់
សូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ